I'm Sara Whyman.
And I'm Phil Whyman.
Between us, we have investigated countless locations in our search for proof of the paranormal.
We are invited to question the unexplained, to uncover what may be lurking in the shadows. With many reported hauntings throughout the UK, no two investigations are the same. Now, together with a team of experienced investigators, we continue to seek evidence to prove whether a haunting can be validated or not.
From a selection of cases we each receive, we will come together to pick the most interesting and ask the question,
are you haunted?
Bringing a haunted beauty salon to the table. The sounds of doors closing, unseen hands moving equipment, and hair being pulled. It sounds like a really interesting venue, and I want to investigate it.
My venue is a house that dates back to the 1950s. Occupants have reported noises like footsteps walking up and down the stairs, bathroom taps being turned on their own, and a strange noise coming from the attic. Sounds interesting? Will anybody else want to do it?
So I'm here again with my haunted pub. It's got such a huge and sinister history that I think it deserves another shot at the vote. Remember, the landlady and the staff don't even go upstairs alone. I really want to get into this venue.
Okay, we've all had time to look at the venues, three venues as usual, but the big question, again, is who wants to go where? Sarah.
I would like to go to the pub, please.
Sarah's going to the pub, gin and tonic. Jane.
It's Sarah's round, I'm to the pub with her.
Oh, there's a surprise, eh? Two to the pub. Dale.
Well, I'm beautiful enough. So I don't need to go to the beauty salon. Okay. I might go to the pub with the ladies.
Are you sure you don't want to go to the beauty salon?
Absolutely positive. Right.
Okay, so Dale's
getting expensive this round.
It is. But this is another handbag to dance around. Ben.
Can I go to the pub, please?
You can go to the pub if you want. You've got some money.
No, mum's fine.
Oh, fair. So that's four out of five then, all go to the pub. It's going to be lonely, isn't it, for me? So I think I'll go to the pub. Get the rounds in, Sarah. We're off to the pub. But whose venue was it? She's won and she's getting the drinks in. Bonus. We're off. We're off to the pub for Sarah's drinks.
My name is Elizabeth Mitchell and I'm the landlady of the Jubilee, the formerly of the Portman and Pickle in Halifax, West Yorkshire. I came and took this pub on the 4th of March 2019. I don't live on the premises because of things that go on here and there's too much activity.
Thank you.
I've spoke to most of everybody that's actually run this pub in the last few years, and they've all had experiences and said that there's a lot of things that go on here. Since I've come here, I've enjoyed being here but I know there's quite a few different spirits here that reside here. I reckon there's about five on top floor, and I could say quite a few downstairs in the pub. They like to make themselves known to us during week. It just depends on how busy the pub is and how much energy they're actually getting off the customers. Tonight we've had the alarms going off three times. Did you hear them? Yeah. So three times. That's just telling me that they were letting me know that they're here. There was always rumours about this room that we're actually in was the gambling room back in the early 60s, 50s and 40s, going back up to the Victorian days. And they used to do a lot of gambling here. And it was obviously dodgy gambling, so people had the throat slit and was actually murdered in this room as we speak. So it's very interesting to find out what actually is going on here, and you know, who actually resides here. I have a member of staff that was now actually 62. She actually worked here when she was 15 and 16 year old back in the late 60s, and she said that there was a lot of activity that went on here. A lot of people were murdered up here. A lot of things were shoved under carpet, and there was actually a brothel. There was a lot of prostitutes that actually used all these rooms upstairs with the punters. So I came here with my cousin Michael, and I decided, oh, come on, we're going to ghost hunt upstairs. And he was actually scared. And I was like, oh, there's not to be scared of, the dead can't harm you. So I was actually running around with my phone trying to video, and he was actually running off into rooms and stuff. And then we started seeing shadows going on the wall on the first floor in the living quarters. And then we started hearing like doors closing and stuff, and there were actually nobody there. And it got to the stage where Michael got that scared, we had to actually leave the premises because the pub were actually closed at the time. So we actually left, but when we were coming onto the bar, glasses were shattering in his hands. They'd not even been in the dishwasher, not even been under hot water, and they just literally shattering in his hands. Then we started hearing knocking on the doors, so then when we was looking around to see who was there, there was actually nobody there. When we come to cashing up on a tight, and it's when you're on your own, I've experienced it, Kath's experienced it, and so did Michael. When we was actually on his own, we heard footsteps and like dragging across the floor. It was actually coming from the living quarters, but none of us would dare come upstairs to have a look at it, to be quite fair, because we were like a bit scared, and it makes my stomach churn. It scares me a bit, so I just don't want to go and examine on my own.
Okay, here we are. It's a Saturday evening, and that can only mean one thing if we're all together. It's another investigation. This time the venue is Sara's, so give us the information on the location.
Okay. Well, welcome to the Jubilee here in Halifax. Now, this pub has been known by many different names. So I've got my history here, so I'm just going to read out some of the notes that I've been making while I've been searching online. So originally it was called the Wheat Sheaf. It was built in around 1891. It then went on to be called the William Dayton. Now, William Dayton used to be locally known as a hangman. He was an excise man, and he was murdered by the Cragvale coiners. He wasn't murdered here, but this pub was dedicated to him in the form of the rename. Then went on to become the Portman and Pickles, and it was a Portman and Pickles named after two local actors that were originated from Halifax. And then it became the Jubilee in 2012, and that was to recognise the Queen's Jubilee, Golden Jubilee. Yeah. When I've just been literally talking to Liz downstairs and a few of the regulars that come into the pub, this has always been as a reputedly haunted venue. It has been investigated before, but only a couple of occasions. Mm. Activity, we're talking things like footsteps, dragging noises, doors banging, people knocking on doors and then when they're opening there's nobody there. Dark shadows have been seen. The other thing is, I've just been downstairs and I've been talking to Liz, and she was showing me there's a CCTV system that they've got set up down there, and one night they captured something on the CCTV and it was swinging across the camera, so she's taken a screenshot of it. And I don't know, I find it very strange. I'm not one for orbs or anything like that, or light anomalies, but I've got a picture of it. I got her to send it to me on my phone. See what you guys think of that.
Oh my God. That is absolutely, if that's what it looks like.
Wow,
weird, isn't it?
And you can, it's coming right from the top. Oh, it is, isn't it? Jesus.
Oh my God. That's not actually there.
No.
That's a noose.
It looks like a noose, doesn't it?
Yeah, I see. I'm sure Phil put this on the edit. Look, yeah.
It's really weird, isn't it?
And I remember saying that's a new CCTV system as well.
Yeah,
this is not something that's got an image built into its screen.
You can see it actually goes, you can see it.
It's sort of like in position, isn't it?
That's really quite well defined, isn't it?
That is phenomenal.
Right, okay. So I've just been finding out how to lock up the building. Have we got some sort of a plan?
Yes. Myself and Ben going down to the cellar.
Okay.
We're going to have a look around there, look through the little hole in the wall down to the blocked off room that's got a table in it.
Yeah.
Apparently. Right. Let's go with that.
You're coming with me, Sarah, and we're going to go down to the main pub area and the lounge where the guy comes out of the toilets. Is it a soldier, I believe? All that area, we're going to look down there.
Right.
So you're going to the pub?
Yeah.
Shock.
Right, okay then, okay. Let's go. It's
let's
late.
Go,
let's
guys.
Come on.
Good luck.
See you soon.
See you soon.
Where are we going?
To the bar.
Okay.
Then down.
Obviously.
Obviously.
Creepy. Oh, ho, look at that. Bloody hell.
Right, so we're going down to the cellar. Oh my goodness. Does this door close behind me? I'm going to leave it open.
Make sure it doesn't lock us down here. I don't really want to be trapped in a cell.
No, so yeah, I'll lock from this side. Right, it's shut too.
Okay.
Oh, wow.
Whoa.
So...
Oh, we got a tunnel.
So then, for those people watching at home, on the CCTV, as Tim and myself are looking at it, the top left is this corridor straight in front of us here. Okay. The top right is one of the rooms in the upper floor, looking down the corridor into another room. The bottom left is another room that's upstairs.
Yeah.
Again, you can see a bit of the room and you can see the corridor into another room. Mm. And the bottom right, as we look at it, is where we did the interview.
Gambling room.
The gambling room, yes. Yeah. Where a lot of weird things apparently, gruesome things apparently happened.
Yeah, nasty stuff.
So this is the first time myself and you have been down to the cellar.
Yes.
Everybody else, I think, has already been down here. So... what we're looking for now is the blocked-off room.
Yeah, blocked-off room with the table.
Blocked-off room. The corridor that no one likes.
I hate corridors.
This is bright down here.
True, but I hate corridors all the time.
I know.
It's my least favourite thing. Oh no, there's no way.
That's the hole.
Is there a table in there? Can you see it? Right, come here, I think.
Yes, there is.
Wait, table
there's
that way.
A table there.
Hold on, let me come around.
Once you look back on night vision.
Yeah, there's loads of cobwebs.
Oh, I can't really see it, can you?
It's literally here.
Have you got a torch?
I have.
Got a radio, I've got a radio with me.
Got two radios.
Alright, okay.
So we're down in the main bar. The back part of the lounge, really, would you call it?
This is the very back part. I don't think you can get any further back than this.
No natural light, no windows or anything back here.
No.
What activity? Is this? It's near to where the soldier comes out, isn't
Apparently
it?
Apparently a soldier's been seen coming out of the sort of male toilet area, which is literally just round the corner
just
from
there.
Where we are. And Liz was telling me that when she was looking at the CCTV, she could see somebody that was sat in one of these far chairs.
Oh, gosh,
well.
Yeah, she said that, didn't she?
So, yeah, lady. So CCTV camera's up there. So it was this area that we're sat in here.
Yeah,
she
I think
saw,
it was this back area.
Yeah, she saw a lady sat here with blonde hair.
Right, so I'm taking this chair through to the cellar, we're going to have a look through that hole in the roof.
See what's up there.
And see what's up there, and hopefully no spiders jump on my head.
Well, that'll be more entertaining, honestly. Screaming like a little girl.
Scream like a girl?
Yes. No, here we go. The hole in the ceiling.
Hole in the roof.
I'm pepping myself. Right, let me just show you this first of all. Bear with. Right, so Ben has already shown you this, but this is the hole in the cellar, which leads through to another room. You can see a table there. I'm not sure what that is. I'm going to have a look in a second. There's a table there. So this used to be a room, which has been blocked off. That table...
What was that? Move, like dragged.
Sorry?
It sounded like something were dragged. Like,
whereabouts?
Just behind me there. Or like maybe like a whisper. Or like...
I heard something.
Like a kind of sound. Like a whisper.
Okay.
Like,
I don't know. Yeah, I thought I heard something like that.
Wasn't this machine like this, isn't it?
No, that's a boiler.
Well, if there's anybody here with us, anyone that used to frequent this building, perhaps you used to occupy the gambling rooms upstairs. Perhaps you came to some grief here. Are you still here? Is anybody still here? Can you give us an indication that you're here if you are? Is anybody in the room known as the gambling room where the wicker basket is? Can you move something on there or in that room that we can see? Are you capable of moving something? There's plenty of things on the floor. Can you move one of the things on the floor?
If this was your regular haunt,
see what you did there.
Yeah, did you see that?
Yeah, clever.
If this is where you used to come to have a relaxing time with your friends, do you want to come and join us now?
We've saved you a seat.
We've saved you lots of seats.
Yeah.
Plenty of chairs here. Come and say hello to us. See, I can hear quite a lot because we're in a pub. There's obviously
chillers
that are going, so there's quite a lot of white noise that's going on
right
now. Right,
so in the hole in the cellar, you'll see a table. That table is too big to go through said gap. So that table has been up there since it was all boarded off and blocked off.
Do we know when that is?
No, not at the moment. So you can see tiles all around, and it's just one, well, small room.
It's all in there, just a table.
Yeah, just a table. And something else, but you see the tiling here.
Talking.
It's very old tiling. Say old, probably 40s, 50s.
Oh.
Do you want to raise your camera up more so you can see more? Yeah.
Now I'm trying to get the height.
That was the noise again.
I don't know what that noise is.
Sounds like something's being dragged.
Yeah, something.
Do you want one of my crazy elaborate explanations?
Go on.
It sounded to me like if someone was to roll a biro across the floor, a biro pen.
Yeah, yeah, I'll give you that. So there's something. So there's something in here making a noise.
Yeah.
Now, obviously, it's a cellar, so there are lots of equipment in here.
I think it might just be the
boiler.
I
think it might just be the boiler or something to do with the electric. It
sounds like it's coming from this bit.
Yeah. But there are noises that we keep hearing that we can't explain.
Yes.
To remind you guys that in some of the rooms there are lines made with the...
It's very dark in there.
Not cross over those lines.
Let's go first. Watch your footing. No, just put... Have you got a towel?
Yeah.
Watch the glass.
Right,
may I
turn it
off? Do you want to? No, I'm fine. So this room is the room where apparently was a bit of a gambling den.
Yeah.
And apparently lots of violence occurred in this room. We're talking like torture, people having like hands chopped off. There's told that somebody had their throat slit and they were murdered in this room. I have to say, from being downstairs in the bar area to coming up here, just coming up the top stairs, and I don't even know whether or not it's a psychological thing. It quite possibly could be, but there is definitely a different feeling up here.
This is why I hate hallways. Never know when something's behind you or not. And this shot is the worst kind of shot for a hallway.
Yeah, it
does. Oh, this is something straight out of a horror movie, isn't it, this? Walking in, you just see like a little girl just sitting in the corner crying.
Are there any spirits that relate to this building?
Footsteps. Footsteps. Did you hear that?
Mm-hmm.
Where the footsteps coming from? Down here?
Up there.
Sound like it came from above.
Okay. But there's nobody above us.
If there's anybody here, anybody up on this top floor with us, if you can hear me, can you make a noise, please?
I think it's because I've gotten back to that room bit. I feel like you know, it's, like there's somebody there.
Do you?
Yeah, that I think it's just because I'm feeling exposed because I like loft hatch.
It's really freaking you out, that, isn't it?
Yeah, I don't like it.
Who knows what kind of things have gone on in these rooms.
Could earn a bob or two tonight.
Yeah, well, what did she say the name of that?
Oh, I've forgotten. It was,
Is it Lily something?
I think it might have been, yes.
What was that?
I heard it. I think it might have been, yes.
What was that?
I heard it. I think it might have been, yes.
What was that?
I heard it.
At this point, Sara and Jane thought the noises were Ben and Dale returning to the hub. But as the next clip shows, they didn't move until after they had heard the noises.
We're now going to go get some batteries because the camera is dying and we need batteries and light to see. So, away we go.
Right, we're coming back up.
So that wasn't them coming back up then? Before?
No. Oh, where
are you opening doors?
Don't know. That's them. Oh, that's interesting then.
I had a voice. I thought I would. I need to check that because that's weird. Dale?
Yeah, go on.
Did you not come up earlier? So earlier, when you said you were going to come up, you didn't?
No, we didn't come up this way. We went to the bar area. We went around the bar area.
Okay, that's kind of weird.
Just so you know, Sara and Jane, we're going back downstairs.
Feels like I can hear music.
No, can you hear them footsteps? Sara, come on.
If there are any spirits here, come forward to myself and Ben. We're down in the cellar.
Can't see anything.
Come and show yourself. Can you give us a light? Make a noise? Can you touch one of us? We've had so many reports of haunted happenings here at the Jubilee. Come and prove it to us. Come and show yourself.
It's just pitch black in this room, from what I can see. That's because I'm holding the camera, but still.
Come and talk to us.
What the fuck?
Oh my god.
Hello? Holy shit. What the fuck was that?
Something moved.
What the fuck?
Oh my god.
Hello?
Alright.
Oh my god, hello?
I'm trying to give another 10 minutes, guys, and then we'll have a quick break, yeah?
Has anyone just made a large banging noise just above us, above the bar, in the bar?
No, not us.
Is that it?
Almighty fucking crash, from the cellar area.
No, not us.
And again, not us.
Fucking hell.
That's behind me. God, that gave me an heart attack.
Shit!
Never turn around so fast.
Just an almighty bang.
Like something falling over.
As though something's fallen over.
Would it have been on camera?
Definitely.
Almost certainly.
I hope so.
Are you steaming over there to take it out?
No. Fucking hell.
Get over there and check it out.
Oh my god.
Sara and I'll go.
No, it wasn't in the back,
yeah.
It was down here.
Yeah, you do once you say the banter
down. Tell me it wasn't here. It was down in the cellar, not actually.
The noise came from down in the cellar.
What's it say?
The noise came from down in the cellar.
Yeah, one of the off rooms from where we were.
Have you checked it?
Bloody hell, no.
Yeah, we're down in what we think is the room it's come from. We can't see anything different. Oh, I'm shaking like a leaf.
Right, Dale and Ben have just heard a loud crash coming from down in the cellar area.
Sorry, I'm going to go look after them because they're both scared.
I'm going to go and see if there's anything.
Were you in the bar area and you heard it come from the cellar, or were you in the cellar?
Next to the street, and the bang came from behind us.
What was that?
Oh, yeah. Something else has just gone off.
Oh, fucking bloody hell.
It's alright, that was Sarah. We absolutely packed our pants. We were, I'll show you now, we were down there.
Do you know how loud it was, right? Deal. Grab that and rattle it. That's what it sounded like, if you rattled that.
Yeah, it was as loud as that, but we were both...
In there.
In here.
Oh, interesting.
We were both here.
It came from down this way, like... This area.
And we were both effectively facing that way. And all of a sudden, massive crash. It wasn't a plasticky sound though. It was more metallic.
Yeah, it was clatter.
So it was as loud as that.
Right.
But more metallic. It was a clatter.
Wasn't any of the beer pumps or anything like that?
No. No, there's no beer pumps down there. It came from down there.
What the fuck?
Oh. Okay.
It sounded like, honestly, like something just got pushed over.
It sounded like something like that had fallen over.
Like a barrel going over?
No.
No.
They were already up. Oh, like
I
that.
Can't explain... Oh, fucking cobwebs. Ooh. I can't explain what it was. I can't explain what it was.
Oh, what about this? What's this? Going?
What's that, sorry?
Was that down there before? I like this.
I don't know.
Well, just tell me again what exactly it sounded like. If you could sort of like say it was like, I don't know, just describe it.
I can't. I don't know how.
It was like something falling over, honestly. It was
that loud.
It didn't sound like it was close, but it sounded like it was definitely like on this in this room kind of thing.
Yeah, it was very close.
Not super close, but
not
like,
next to us. Yeah. It was from another room. I say we were down there, it was from in here is what it sounded like.
You just asked out if it could make like a bang or something, and then it just went.
Yeah, we said, come forward, come let us know. Is there anything here? We've heard many reports of things happening, haunted happenings here. Can you let us know you're here? Bang, 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 bang. Like, no. Honestly, it was so loud.
You asked for it.
Yes, yeah.
Yes.
Ah, hang on a minute.
Wasn't that?
Right. I'm just thinking, we stood next to an ice maker. The ice maker went off. Did it sound like that?
No. It was louder than that. It was more...
It's just, like, it made as much noise as that, but was much louder.
It was more like the lid coming down. It was more like that.
Okay.
In volume. It was a lot louder. Ben, can you just go back into that room? Take my torch. Go back into that room, and I'll drop this lid. And see if you can compare the volume to what we heard.
Just send me in the darkest room in the building by myself.
Jane, go with him.
Come on, little Benjamin, I'll look after you.
So let me know when you're in position, Ben.
Wait for Jane.
You're right.
Right, let me just move over here and get you.
Go for it, Dale.
Right, so Ben is now where I was, where both me and Ben were.
It was at that volume, definitely.
Was it the same type of sound,
though? No. It was
more sounded metallic-y.
It sounded more random kind of thing. Like a lot more sounds in it.
Did it sound like that?
No, that was way too quiet.
So it's not the ice maker?
Like, you know how the ice maker kind of like bumps around? Like that, yeah?
But a lot louder.
Like that, but
times,
like a lot.
Five times as loud.
Right.
It was a proper bang.
It's like if someone was to boot the machine, basically.
Yeah, that would have shocked me. But it'd have been quiet, and I've had to listen for it, I think. Whereas what we heard...
was a lot louder.
Almost certainly have got picked up on camera as a loud sound. I hope. I really hope.
It definitely did. I'm not even kidding. It did.
Okay. Right, let's go and have a break.
Yeah.
And see who wants to come down here next.
We've just come up from the cellar.
You crapped yourself down there.
I crapped myself, yeah. A mighty bang, huge, massive thud. Can't explain it.
I thought it was the ice machine at first.
Yeah, there's an ice maker down there. But
it was a lot louder than, yeah, like five times louder, I'd say.
Yeah. I really don't know what it was, but it really shook me up.
Well, Tim and myself are now in the bar area, and I'm just going to wander around so you can see what the bar area looks like.
Just over there, old stained glass window with one of the previous pub names. Portman and Pickles, after two gentlemen. Surnames there. So yeah, it's showing some of its history, even just in appearance, but at the same time, because all the equipment's functioning and there's emergency lights that stay on, it does lose a bit of atmosphere, but at the same time, if something's going to make a noise in the cellar, hopefully we may hear it and possibly venture down. We'll see.
So, I'm just going to sit on the windowsill, I think.
Okay.
Get comfy. To my left is the toilet.
There was a lady down in the bar earlier who stopped me and said that she'd stayed in this room. And this is when she woke up and looked out. There was a woman walking up and down the corridor.
Well, right, okay.
So myself and Ben are taking second sitting on the hub. Phil and Tim have gone downstairs into the bar area. And Jane and Dale are just in the room sort of next door to us here. For the moment, I think they're going to have a wander around this floor in a little while. Start to get light.
Yeah. Summertime.
Can you walk down to the bathroom area?
Okay. Grab my torch.
Smells like being doing some joinery.
Yeah, the doors are new. The doors are freshly hung. This is one of the nicer rooms.
Is anyone coming round with us tonight?
What was that? Did you hear that?
I heard something then, yes.
That's growl.
It could have been, but then I moved and the floor moved.
No, it was from behind me.
I know that was, yeah.
Hey, it sounded like a growl. Like a grrr. From behind me. Can you just check with Phil and Sarah and Ben to make sure they've not just moved?
Sarah, you and Ben have not just moved, have you?
No, we sat still.
We heard a little bit like a growl.
Okay, definitely not us. We've not been growling.
Good to hear.
Reassuring.
Fighting the urge.
Yeah, that's what I heard from up there. Up.
I don't know if I'd have said a growl or more a grumble, but then again.
Yeah.
But it was if I had to choose between male and female, it was male.
It was male, definitely.
What's that? Somebody just make a bang. Who's doing that? Somebody just make a bang. Who's doing that?
When you just as you radioed, I called the tail end of it.
Like a.
Did you make a bang?
weeding it in the bar now. Phil's still holding the camera filming us, and I've just got a radio in my hand. And to me, it was from the front of the bar area, but I don't know if it was upstairs. Yeah, it's from the front.
From the front?
To me, it was from the front.
Come forward and tell me a story.
I can hear somebody moving about.
I just heard that.
Can you radio? Because I don't want to.
Is anybody moving about at the moment? Did you make any noise while doing so?
Only probably very faint footsteps that you have heard us, and there's a couple of creaky floorboards down here, but nothing over the top.
It was more than that, I thought.
I would have thought so.
Well, excuse me.
Excused.
But yeah, it sounded like someone was moving around.
Is there anyone down here with us? In the bar? What the fuck were that?
The fuck shit was that?
It was a fucking whisper. Did you hear it?
Get them to come down here now, because I ain't moving.
Can all people upstairs come to the bar here, please? All people, don't piss about girls. Just go, go, go. Don't come tumbling down at high speed, just nice and easy. I heard a fucking whisper then. Yeah, it was
like a whisper. Of course I fucking heard it.
It was a voice. You don't see him like this often. Nothing normally happens to poor Mr. Phil, but yeah, I heard. Oh, that's ankle.
Yeah.
I hope that picked it up good on there.
Oh, here,
here. Here, here. Just heard a voice. Like a whisper, or it was clear.
We fucking shit ourselves.
He jumped out. He won't face in that way.
Something literally went.
Really?
Honest to fucking God.
On camera?
On camera.
It was going. Yeah.
Where from?
From behind here. I was sat there.
That's where we heard that noise from.
I was sat there.
He was facing me. Now look.
I was sat there talking to him, and I turned the camera and they're like that, and I turned it back, and something went.
Oh, that's giving me
goosies. And I went, get these
goosies as well.
I said, get these down here because I ain't fucking moving.
Jesus Christ. We came from behind the bar.
Wait, film him while he's saying it.
Hello, is anybody going to answer me?
We've just told you to get down here.
It's okay, just come down to the bar, please, sir.
It was behind me, wasn't it? It was definitely
Phil.
Fucking behind me.
Yeah.
What we heard from behind the bar, we heard a noise from this area.
Yeah. Well, we just heard it.
What's going on?
I've just been filming it. Me and Tim have just been filming
it. Phil was there.
I was sat in that corner there, and we were just yattering away. And I turned the camera around there like that, trying to get a shot, trying to think, what the fucking hell is that shot there?
I
thought, that's not very good. So I turned it around like that, and literally something went, "Oh, shit." And I said, he went, "That was you." And I went, "It fucking wasn't."
Are you kidding me?
He went, "That was you. It was your foot." I says, "It wasn't my foot." I says, "Get them down here because I ain't moving." Whatever it was.
It wasn't him.
It wasn't me.
Is that from that corner?
Yeah, that foot upstairs then.
That from this corner?
It was from around here, yeah.
We've already said that there's stuff from this corner.
Yeah.
Twice.
Yeah. But this was like sort of loud and clear, and he's like,
what I heard from this.
He ended up
corner,
quite quick.
And what Tim described it as was someone getting on from a seat. Like
yes.
A
yeah,
nope.
Kind of thing.
No. This was about
some like whisper or something.
It was like, but it was a gruff fucking nasty kind of thing.
Male or female?
Male.
Male.
Do it again.
How loud? Yeah. It was literally this loud. Honest to God, wasn't it? Because
yeah,
he thought
it was
me.
It was. I thought it was his foot.
From round here.
When he turned round.
It was. I was sat here.
From.
I was sat here like this,
yeah,
and I was
here.
Filming Tim.
Yeah.
And I was like that, trying to get a shot there, thinking, "What's that shot?" And I went like that, and then I kind of came back here, and it went. And I went, "What the?" And he's like, "That's you." I went, because I was kind of feeling like this.
His foot at the time, so I thought maybe it was his.
And
leg.
I moved my foot because I heard that noise. I went, "I moved my foot," and he went, "That was you." I says. It wasn't. He says it was. I says it fucking well wasn't.
I meant.
And I went all goosebumpily and all like fucking. And that's when I went, get them down here because I ain't moving.
My arm went with the goosebumps.
Main question.
Yeah.
Will it have been picked up on the camera?
Hopefully yes.
Yeah.
Hopefully yes.
No.
Yeah.
I bet. I brought my camera down. I didn't.
If you had some headphones, you'd probably get a good one on it.
Any explanation whatsoever? It's just like, yeah, can you come down to the bar? It's like.
I'm going to stop this now, so...
Yeah, we just want to explain quick and just see what you lot had to say, and then we'll invent a story for this area.
Yeah, yeah.
And that it was noted before, but it was so loud, that I just... And I thought it was his foot...
So you heard it as well?
I heard
yeah,
it.
Yeah, fucking hell.
I thought his foot had clogged this on that side, and then I looked, no, his foot wasn't that close.
What the fuck?
Fucking told you.
Wow.
God.
Oh my God. Oh my God.
Do it again.
You don't often see your full move at that speed.
Yeah, but we both heard it, didn't we?
Yeah.
You can hear it.
Yeah.
That's crazy, that.
So on the immediate playback, there it is. And obviously you'll see it and hear it on the edit. But...
What the fuck?
His facial reaction.
May I? I'm just going to check. Just to...
It does say something.
Just for peace of mind for myself and...
Give that change on, Mr.
God, that's the air freshener just sprayed.
Yeah. Feature out a bit for...
Just a bit, yeah.
Oh, yeah. It's so nice when you know that it was real, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
But, yeah.
Give me that.
Yeah.
Freaky as hell, but yeah, nice to know that stuff does happen and we've just witnessed some.
Well, I don't know what just happened there to Tim and myself in the bar area. I'm still trying to work it out. I was looking around, see if I can get a shot. And what I can only describe as a harsh whisper suddenly came from the right-hand side of me. I crapped myself. We asked everybody to come down because we got the footage. They had a look at the footage and I think they're just as shocked as I was.
So that was the Jubilee, my venue that actually brought a pub in Halifax with quite a big reputation.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So we had quite an interesting night, but do we think it's haunted? So I'm going to ask Jane first.
I'm going to be to the point and say, yes, I think there's something in there. We heard quite a lot of stuff through the night that we couldn't trace back. And the guys had quite a few bangs and you heard the voice.
Mm.
There was enough to convince me at this point.
You think something's going on
there? Yeah, definitely.
Okay. Dale?
Yeah, the same as Jane. There was so much going off throughout the evening that all of us experienced, really. We all heard something.
Mm-hmm.
Myself and Ben down in the cellar, that huge bang. And as Jane said, Phil's voice. We can't just put it all down to normality.
Right, okay.
Let's say it's not normal, it's paranormal.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I'd say it's haunted. Yeah.
Okay. Ben?
I'd say so, yeah, because a lot of time when you're walking around just those corridors upstairs, it did feel very eerie. It felt like someone was watching you.
Yeah, that was one of the major things that had been said there. Plus, if you remember, we had that photograph. Can you remember that came through with the news?
Yeah, with the news.
That was really unusual. Wow.
Yeah.
So, Phil, quite shaken on your vigil. So you've had time to reflect now, because obviously on the night, things are a little bit different, and you look back.
Mm.
So what do you think?
I can't kind of work out still what that noise was. To me, it definitely sounded like some kind of voice, and Tim thought it was some kind of voice as well. As did you guys when you heard it back.
Yeah.
So that, and based on some of the things that you guys have had, and don't forget that footage where we left the camera running and the noises that were picked up when nobody was there, we were all downstairs. So there's definitely something in the upper floors.
I think it's quite important to point out, because we have listened back, and at the time, and we were aware that there are the squirty air fresheners in the bar.
Yeah.
And we did sort of come away from it and then think afterwards, could it have been the noise of an air freshener coming down?
Mm.
But as we see on the night, one does actually go off while we're there.
Give that change on this.
Oh, that's the air freshener just sprayed.
Yeah, yeah.
And it is a different sound. We've listened back to it on the audio. It does sound like it's kind of a whisper that is saying words, but you can't quite make out what it's saying.
No.
So it is unusual, and we did rule out that kind of air freshener.
Yeah, we did.
We were aware of them being
like
there.
That sound anyway.
And again, I think with the ice maker, because that did make that sort of rattly noise as the ice falls down in the cellar.
Yes.
Hang on a minute.
Wasn't that?
Right. I'm just thinking, we stood next to an ice maker. The ice maker went off. Did it sound like that?
No.
But we were stood there, and it wasn't as loud as what you guys heard at
not
the time.
At all.
I thoroughly enjoyed it. I'm really glad that we did get the chance to go there. I think it's got so much history, and it's quite a dark sort of history to it as well, kind of colourful history. So I'm going to say yes, I also think it's haunted.
Okay, cool.
A grade 2 listed house in a quaint village location, but the owners are frightened to be in there alone. They've been scratched, they've been pushed, and a figure of a crouching woman has been seen upstairs. Wonder what the team will make of this one.
I'm bringing a village hall to the table. It has a reputation locally as being haunted. Figures have been seen in the windows by people walking past when the building's actually empty.
My venue is a rather unusual venue in the fact that we've never ever done anything like this before. It's a fishing trawler where a deckhand has been seen but without any face. We'll also be investigating the nearby museum where lots of strange things have been witnessed.
We've looked at the venues, we've made a decision, and the winner is...